Hi, all right, so got it. So today I'm going to be talking on the top programming languages to check out in 2019. So I am not going to give you my own version of what I think about it. I'm actually going to use statistics by some people who have gone to check things out. So I'm not giving you things that I think are the top. I'm going to use real life statistics to show you what the top languages are. So the first I'm going to use is TOBI Index. So this is the TOBI Index for December 2018. You can check it out using this URL. Now, as you can see, the first language is Java, then C, Python, C++, Visual Basic .NET, C Sharp, JavaScript, and the list goes on. Now, in case you think, why is VB.NET here? And they explain that a lot of professional developers don't really use Visual Basic, but a lot of programs have been built using it. So they have their ways of getting this data. Now, if you look at this, look at the top 10 from Java, C, Python, C++. Let's leave VB.NET for now. Okay, C Sharp, JavaScript. Now, these languages, you will see them appear, maybe not in the same order, but they will appear in top 10 languages in other reviews. So we have the Java, C, Python, C++, C Sharp, JavaScript, PHP. Now, you might say, okay, let's try and choose the best language. Now, I'll advise you, if you're trying to choose your first programming language, you can't really go wrong choosing any of these. Now, if you want to be, now it depends on what you want to do after, because I saw a lot of people ask this question. If you want to go into web design, then you can start with HTML and CSS, and then you can do JavaScript here. Now, JavaScript, you can go to front end or even back end. Now, yeah, you have your various options which you can do. If you want to go for game development, mobile games, you could go for C Sharp or C++. For example, I don't know if you know Unity. That is for game development. Unity 3D uses C Sharp for that programming, and it's really lovely. I actually like to use Unity, but I have not had the time. Now, the other one that uses C++ is called Unreal Engine. So either of these, you can use it for game development. Now, if you want to also go at low-level programming, like building maybe really low level things, deal with microcontrollers and all that, C++ is really nice. C++ is going to be here for a long time. Now, if you're interested in artificial intelligence, statistics, and basically, if you're new to programming, also Python is a nice language, and it's now the default first language in a lot of places and for a lot of people. C, yeah, like C++, they are brothers, kind of. So you have PHP, which is use it for like your framework Laravel. You can use it for your backend development. It's a nice language also, but as a first language, I might not say PHP. Maybe you can start with JavaScript and the likes. Then Objective C, yeah, especially in iOS, when before Swift came out, Objective C was popular, but now you have Swift, which is nice. You also have Go. Man, when it comes to programming languages, you have a lot of options. Now, even if you go down, you see a lot more. Yeah, that is that used for Flutter. And you can see Kotlin down here, you see Rust, but this is just one review by Toby. So let's use another person's analysis. So we're going to use GitHub. Now, GitHub released their own, they call it the State of Octoverse. They released it in November 15th. So now the programming language, they have their own way of doing their own analysis, and they publish their own top programming languages. So on the top, that is, this is top programming languages by repositories created between 2008 and 18. So the top, JavaScript. Yeah, we know, we all love JavaScript. Then the next is Java, Python, PHP and Ruby. Now, like I said, it may not be the same order as what you see here, but very similar languages appear in the top again. Now, top programming languages by contributors as at September 30, 2018. Now, that is like people contributing to these languages projects. The top was JavaScript, Java, Python, PHP, C++. Now, very similar to what we saw here, but we can see Java, JavaScript and Python, PHP, C++, C#, that on the top. And yeah, if we go here, you also see this. So now this is fastest growing contributors. So you have Kotlin and all that. Now let me also answer this question of Kotlin and Java battle. Now, do I think Kotlin will replace Java? Not necessarily. For example, Kotlin became popular when Google announced that Android now supports Kotlin. But the truth is, Android isn't where Java is only used. In fact, Java was around way back before Android. So let's look at Java. It was language of the year in 2005. Now, Android was initially released at 2008. Now, Java was the language of the year 2005. So before Android came to be, Java had been reigning. So because Kotlin is popular on Android, doesn't really affect Java. Yes, maybe less Java projects. Java is still here to stay. Now, JavaScript, really popular, really strong language. It depends on what you want to do. But let's also go to the third review. Now, this third one, PYPL, popularity of programming language, what they do is that they get the popularity based on how often tutorials are searched on Google. So here the number one, as at December 2018, is Python, next Java, then JavaScript, C#, PHP, C++. So these top guys, the top guns, are the same. You keep seeing these top languages time and time again. You see them here, you keep seeing them here. Now, which language should you choose? You can go with any of these if it's your first language. But if it's your second or third language, first, decide what you want to do. Do you want to be a web designer? Or do you want to be a back-end web developer? If you want to be a backend web developer, you can go with Python. It has, you have Flask and Django. You can build APIs, REST APIs with it. You also have Java. You have Spring, you can do. And the popular ones, JavaScript, PHP, you can do things with them. You also have backend .NET frameworks you can use with C#. But popular ones are JavaScript. You can do Node.js and the rest, and PHP, you know, Laravel. Yeah, so that does it. You also have Go, which you can use for your backend development also, and it's a very popular language and increasing very fast. So this, I'm not telling you my top 5 or top 10. I'm just giving you an overview of these top languages that will still be holding our software in 2019. So I've given you 3 different reviews. So this isn't my personal judgment of me saying, okay, my own top language is Swift or R, but this is showing you, okay, these are the top 5. And okay, if I was even to do a top 3, my top 3 would be Python, Java and JavaScript, because anywhere you go to, they're always kind of in the top 3. So look at here, Python, Java, JavaScript. If you come over here, JavaScript, Java, Python. If you come here, Java, C, Python. Yes, it's not as arranged as the boot, but when you come to sum it up, Java, Python, JavaScript, they are ruling everywhere. So that doesn't mean that if you learn C, you're going anywhere. Like if you learn C, you're not wrong. You can learn C++. People hardly learn the wrong language. Like you don't learn a language and you end up by saying, oh man, I wasted my time. Really, even if you learned, let's go down, even if you learned Erlang, like you still have, like you've not lost anything. I'm just showing you the languages that are moving, so that apart from learning, yes, you can also guide your career to know what skills you have are marketable. So hope this was very informative to you, and have a nice day.